You can't trust nobody. I don't fuck these niggas. Fuck 12. Look what kind of picture they try to paint on me. Drink? I know. What you tell them, son?
My bad.
High school could be the peak of your life or the beginning of something greater. Many experiences to have and many memories to make. Lots of mentors and asshole teachers to meet. You may lose and gain friends throughout, but in the end, that doesn't even matter. In the end, what really matters is who you really are
and how much you've changed mentally and emotionally.
High school is different for everybody. We all have our own issues. We all have our own heartbreaks. And we all have our own desires. We all have our own answers to questions we're given.
Hi, my name is Javier. I'm 18. I'm a senior at Pittsburgh High School, California.
I'm Carlos, and I'm 17. I go to Pittsburgh High School, California, as well as home.
Kid Cudi fan.
Calling this
up. I'm sophomore. I'm Sergio. I'm 16. I like fishing.
No, you don't.
This ain't your interview.
I'm Donnie. You already know. Yeah, I go to Pitt.
Senior.
I'm 17. Yeah. There you go. Senior. You already know.
My name is 510 Sean. I'm not gonna tell you my real name because that's classified. I know y'all like the bonnet hat. Rock with me. Creating new styles, bro.
My name is Joel Messina. I'm a senior at Pitt.
I'm Jose. I'm an upcoming photographer here in the Bay Area. About to be 18. Yeah, that's me.
Alright, Jacob.
What's up, boy?
How you doing?
I'm doing alright, bruh.
You already know who it is. Y'all see it. I don't even need an introduction. Look, my face is on all the billboards, everything. James, number one, one and only. 165 champ.
So this is, my name is Mr. Finn. I'm here at P205 on P-Side. Come through anytime.
Don't worry about like what other people think of you as much. Cause I remember when I was around that age, you feel me? I don't know, I used to be so worried about what people would think of me. And I used to avoid certain people just cause, you know, I didn't want to get judged. So yeah.
A lot of people will come and go, and high school is a lot harder than they make it out to be. It's pretty easy if you just like decide to just coast through it.
I would tell him to stay on top of his work, bro, because catching up is not fun. I promise you it's not.
I'll tell them, like, through high school you're going to experience a bunch of different challenges, but just try to stay true to yourself and not try like your best not to overthink.
Take your time. Do not rush things, bro. Take your time. Make a lot of friends, for sure. Don't try to be alone. Being alone here in high school is good at sometimes, but I say have your own circle. Have your friends that you can depend on. And just take things slow one at a time.
You know what? I would tell that nigga to not care. Can we say bad words?
Yeah.
Okay. I would tell him to not really care what anyone thinks. You know, the younger me was just so aware of what everyone thought about me. I felt like everyone was just looking at me. But then, as time went on, I felt like nothing I did really mattered. But it also was a good thing for me to know that. Tell him with the 14-year-old me that I would really, like, do a lot of things that I wasn't doing before. You know, get ready for a crazy experience in terms of me, like, going out. I didn't expect my younger self, at least when I was that age, to be going out as much as I did now. Just get ready.
I would tell that little boy, do better. Don't let niggas push you around, bruh. Don't let no one know that. Don't let people take advantage of you. Don't let them push you over. Don't fuck up, bruh. Listen to what mom says. Listen to what the people say. Cause they're right. Cause right now, we're in an alright spot, but we're stressing. And we don't wanna stress. We wanna live, not survive.
One thing I don't really
only thing I really regret is like not putting myself out there as much and not joining the soccer team. That's like one thing because I love soccer. Mm-hmm. I just never put my time into like to join.
I really do regret not going to any football games. Mm-hmm. You know, I've only been to one out of my 4 years of high school. I went to the very last football game of the year of my last year of high school. And people have told me that they've been like really fun and you make new friends and some other stuff. But I regret not going to that because I'm a really social person. What I do not regret probably not doing my work. Mm-hmm. And you know, as bad as that sounds, it all ended up paying off for me. Things just worked out. I ended up being able to come back to Pitt with the majority of my credits and just like, you know, having everything given to me and basically having everything played out for me. It just felt like I was blessed. Me not doing my work just paid off basically. But that doesn't mean don't do your work. Mm-hmm. Do your fucking work, yeah.
I gotta say like one thing I regret not doing is probably like leadership or something. Cause like I've always been like really social. I feel like leadership was been like a lot of fun.
I regret doing a lot of sports, going to school events like dances, stuff like that. Did cello a couple years ago. I used to be like alone in the hallway most of the time. I wish I would like be with my friends out here in the quad and stuff, you know, socializing.
I regret not coming here a lot more. There was a lot of events that I just ended up missing. I kind of want to go like look back on them now.
I regret not playing football, to be honest. Like when the whole COVID like pandemic started, I wanted to start football, but around when the pandemic started, canceled football.
I regret, okay, this is like a pretty common answer. I regret not doing work. That's just the only thing that sucks, is not doing work, because now we have to fucking catch up. We already don't like work, and now we have to do more work because we didn't do the work before. Like, bro, it's just so much work now. As a personal, like, person-wise, like, nah, I feel like every choice I made, like, I really thought like, hard about it. Because, like, right now where I'm at as a person, I like it. It's cool. It's like, my friends are dope, the way I think and shit. It's like, it's not that, like, I don't care, but it's just, like, not, like, the shit I used to overthink about before, the little shit. I don't even care about that shit no more. We on to, like, bigger and better things. We think about the present here now.
So I'm really gonna miss high school for these purposes. My friends, such as you, Hari, I love you, I love you.
Me too.
I love all my other friends like Brian and Jose and all of them. I really enjoy my teachers like Miss Beardsley, some teachers like Mr. Svan, Miss Wagner. They all have taught me like valuable lessons that I've actually used throughout my life. So that's probably something I can value here.
For me, my boy Jorge right here behind the camera, you already know. I don't know, I made lifelong connections.
Wait, let's go chess.
Found a place where I could be comfortable, stuff like that, yeah.
Nothing! Nah. Fucking, this shit's terrible though, bro. Like, everyone, oh, you're gonna miss high school. No. I don't like, high school is like, I don't know, just the school-wise. But friends, it's awesome, it's dope. I get to hang out with my fucking boys every day, talk shit, fucking laugh, do other stuff. But like, can't say, because I'll probably go to jail. It's okay. But yeah, I mean, it was alright. I like, it was a cool experience for my friends and stuff.
Sure, most of my memories is me, bro, so fun.
This is very fun.
It's worth a lot, actually. I'm gonna be the first one of like my entire family to walk the stage, because my mom got pregnant with my older sister, so she wasn't able to finish high school. My older sister wasn't able to finish because she got pregnant with my niece. My older brother got locked up before he got to finish, so I'm gonna be like the first one to walk the stage, so it kind of means a lot.
I think the biggest challenge is time and having enough of it. Also resources. A lot of the resources I use for class, I have to get myself. I think too, it's trying to help as many kids as possible and realizing that I'm not gonna touch every single person every day. I'm not gonna get to them every day. Being okay with doing my best, that's a challenge. Because there's always something else to do. There's always an email to send or someone else to give attention to, and I'm only one person, so trying to do it all is hard. But yeah, the joys of teaching far outweigh the challenges, though, I gotta say. I don't know. I feel like they have to answer that question. I don't know if I can answer that question. I hope they would describe me as someone who has integrity, someone who has who's respectful and kind, honest and truthful. Telling the truth is really important to me. I guess a good person, I don't know. That's kind of what I hope they would say. I hope I do, yeah. I mean, I know for sure, like, there are students that I work with closely, whether it's with the poetry club or in my classes, and, you know, they tell me that, you know, I help them with whatever, but I hope there's kids also that, you know, maybe I planted a seed and it didn't blossom until later, and maybe I helped them a little bit. That's enough for me, you know, even if it was just like some motivation on one day, or a congratulations or something, yeah.
I'm a real pop star. I'm a real rock star.